Yes, Mandira, how are you?
I'm fine, ma'am.
Okay. So today we will be beginning the poem Labanum Top by Ted Hughes. Okay. Now see, this is the poem is divided into three parts. The first part describes the poet describes the Lebanon tree. Okay. The condition of the Lebanon tree is described in the first part. And in the second stanza, that is the second part, the arriving of the bird is described. The goldfinch bird arrives on the top of the tree. That is described in the second part. And in the third and the final part, the leaving of the bird to the infinite is described. So the poem is about the Lebanon tree, which is in a miserable condition because it is still and silent, which is compared to death-like. Okay, and then suddenly one day, a goldfinch bird arrives and the tree becomes lifelike. Okay, because of the sounds and the twitterings and the chirpings made by the bird and its young ones, the tree is lively and full of life once again. But then what happens? Again, the bird decides to fly away and the bird flies to the infinite, towards the infinite, means towards the sky. And then the tree is same as before, means the tree again becomes still and silent. Okay, so this is the summary, the introduction of the poem. We will be doing it line by line, and then I will also be discussing the literary devices that is used in the poem. Okay. Now, before I begin, I would like to tell you who was Ted Hughes. He was an English poet and he was also a translator and children's writer. Okay. And he was considered one of the best 20th century writer. Okay. Now, this poem, The Lebanon Top, see, the title itself suggests that it is about the tree. Now, the Lebanon is a tree. It is a short tree with yellow flowers and small hanging branches. Okay. Now, here the poet describes, in the first stanza, the poet describes the condition of the Lebanon tree. Okay, I'm reading. You just follow the book, page number 31. Okay. The Lebanon top is silent, quite still. In the afternoon, yellow September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. So in the first stanza, the poet, he is observing the tree and he gives us the information that it is silent. See, he is saying the tree is silent, quite still. Please underline that line. And he tells us that it is autumn season and the leaves have turned yellow and they are falling off the tree and even its seeds have fallen down. See, and the month is September, September sunlight. So see, he uses the color yellow. The image of color yellow is used. The tree also has yellow flowers and then the leaves have turned yellow and the sunlight is also yellow. So here the yellow color signifies, it is an image, it signifies that the flowers of the tree, it signifies beauty, death and silence. Why? Because see, the flowers of the tree are yellow, which is beautiful, and then this September sunlight, which is also yellow, is silent. Okay, it is it tells us that there is no rain, it is not windy, and it is daylight and sunlight, and then the leaves are also yellowing, which signifies death. So yellow color is used as an image here and it signifies beauty, silence and death. So in the first stanza, the poet tells us about the condition of the Lebanon tree, which is still very still, death-like, and it is not in a good condition. It is in a miserable condition. And then in the second stanza, you will see that how the condition of the tree instantly changes when a goldfinch bird comes and sits on it and does its activity. Okay. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Okay, now see here the poet tells us that the Lebanon tree is silent till the bird arrives. See, till the goldfinch comes, and then you know that when the birds and they fly and sit on a branch, and then they make those twittering sounds and chirrups, and that enlightens the tree. Okay, it fills the tree with life. Okay, the tree is no more still, and there is no more silence. A suddenness. Now the bird sits on the branch of the tree with a suddenness. Suddenness means an abrupt movement, okay, made by the bird. It suddenly comes and sits on the branch, and then it is making the twittering sound and the chirping sound, and the bird is compared to a sleek lizard. Okay, now see, the bird is the bird instantly comes and sits on the branch and looks here and there with sudden movement, okay, just like a lizard. Okay, have you ever noticed a wall lizard? How quick
yes, it
vanishes if it sees some danger. So similarly, the bird comes and sits on the branch of the Lebanon tree, but the bird is very alert and cautious. Okay, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Please underline this line, it is very important. Then what happens? The bird has made a nest inside the Lebanon tree, and then what she does, the bird enters the thickness, and then what happened, there are young ones, okay, the birds nestlings are there, and the moment they see the mother bird, they all start chirping with joy, with great joy. Why? Because they know that the mother bird has brought food for them, and also they were very hungry, and they have seen their mother after a long time. So they are hungry, and they are also happy, and that makes them tweet and they make the chirping sounds a lot more with a lot of joy. So that is compared to the start of a machine. That's why it is said, the poet says, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Okay, as now see, the bird is bringing food for them. So it is like a fuel for the birdlings. So arriving of the bird and giving them food is compared to a start of a machine. Okay, and then the poet says that because they are very happy, the kids are very happy, the birds, birdlings are very happy, and so they make a lot of noise, and then the entire tree there is it is encircled with those noise, and the tree is once again lifelike, and it is very happy. Okay. Clear?
Yes.
Yes. Of the chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings, the whole tree trembles and thrills. So previously we had seen that the tree was silent, the atmosphere was silent, everything was silent, the tree was death-like. But the moment the goldfinch bird comes and she wants to feed its young ones, and when the young ones sees their mother, they are making such a lot of noise, the entire tree and the entire atmosphere becomes lifelike. Okay, and the whole tree trembles and thrills. Underline this line also. It is the engine of her family. This line also you underline, it is important. Now the poet says that the bird, the mother bird, is like an engine to its family. And not only to its family, it is like an engine to the tree. Because it is providing fuel, that is food to the birds, to the birdlings, and also it is providing thrill, because when the sounds of the young ones twittering and chirping makes the tree lifelike, so that is why it is said that it is like an engine for her family and also for the tree. Okay, she strokes it full and then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. So what happens then, again she shifts to a end of the branch, and there she is covered, because the bird is also yellow and the leaves of the tree are also yellow, the bird is half hidden. Okay, and then what happens, then with eerie delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite. So this line is also important. What happens then, with a strange movement, she again goes to the branch end, and she makes a chirrup sound, and then she decides to carry on her journey, and she flies away towards the infinite. Here, infinite means endless space, and here it means the sky. So the bird, which is like a fuel to the birdlings and also to the tree, when flies away, what happens? The tree again becomes silent and death-like. See in the last line, and the labanum subsides to empty. So the poet, he just sees, he describes the condition of the tree. When the tree was lonely at the beginning of the poem, and it was still and death-like, but then when a goldfinch bird arrives, what happens? The tree becomes lifelike because of the sounds and the twitterings made by the birds and the birdlings. And then what happens when the bird again flies to the sky, to the infinite, towards the infinite, the labanum tree is again, it subsides to emptiness. That means it again becomes still and silent. Okay, now this is the poem. Have you understood, Mandira?
Yes, miss.
Now, one thing also I want to add here, that here the poet also wants to give us a very profound and deep message, that nothing lasts forever. Okay, see the joys, the tree became happy. Okay, when the tree became lifelike and the tree was thrilled, everything, all the entire atmosphere was full of joy, and because it became lifelike. But what happened? That was short-lived. The moment the bird flies away towards the infinite, the tree becomes still again. So we get this message that nothing in this world is permanent, neither the joys nor the sorrows. Joys are also temporary and the sorrows are also temporary. And here at the core, the theme of the poem is, the poet is describing the relationship of the tree and the bird. Okay, they both have a mutual relationship. Why? Because see, the tree is providing shelter to the bird. Okay, if the tree would have not given the shelter to the bird could have not feed its young ones. So the tree is providing shelter to the bird, and the bird is giving the thrill, the lifelike quality to the tree. So both are, there is a mutual relationship between the labanum tree and the goldfinch bird. Okay, it is a very, very short, but a very meaningful and a nice poem. Okay, now see also, because I previously also I told you that during those time, the poets and the writers were very much connected to the nature. He describes the condition of the tree because he might have seen this. He might have seen, observed this. That is why he has observed it and he has written a beautiful poem on it. So this poem describes the relationship, a mutual relationship between the labanum tree and the goldfinch bird. Okay, clear? Have you understood the poem, Mandira?
Yes, ma'am. I clearly understood.
Okay. Any questions to ask?
Miss, what does the phrase her bared face identity marks mean?
Showing her bared face identity marks. Now, this line means that when the bird was, she bought food for the birdling, she gave them the food, and then what happened? She went to the branch end. Okay, and then her face was closed. Okay, her face was covered. Why? Because her feather was also yellow and her identity was secured. Okay, she was not visible because she was sitting, the bird is also yellow, the leaves of the tree are also yellow, so that her identity gets covered. Okay, so that is what it means. Clear?
Clear, miss. Yes.
Anything else, Mandira, you want to ask?
No, miss.
You like the poem?
Yes, miss, of course.
Okay.